Donald Trump's attempt to wrestle back the election spotlight this week may have succeeded, but not in the way some of his allies hoped. The former president, trying to appeal to religious and black voters, seemed to fall back to his default setting of divide and try to conquer.
Do you believe that Vice President Kamala Harris is only on the ticket because she is a black woman?
She was always of Indian heritage, and she was only promoting Indian heritage. I didn't know she was black until a number of years ago when she happened to turn black, and now she wants to be known as black.
Donald Trump, who's made a concerted effort to reach out to black voters, questioning the vice president's racial identity during an appearance before black journalists.
So I don't know, is she Indian or is she black?
It doesn't seem to have been a mistake. At a rally hours later, the campaign displayed this headline: watch Kamala Harris sworn in as first Indian American senator.
Everything about Kamala Harris rollout, it's phony and it's fake.
Earlier in the week, Trump's focus was on religion.
Oh, my beautiful Christians, I love you. You gotta get out and vote.
Urging key voting blocks to support him while also attacking Harris.
She doesn't like Jewish people. She doesn't like Israel.
Harris's husband is Jewish, but that didn't stop Trump.
How does a Jewish person vote for a Democrat? How does a Catholic person vote for a Democrat?
You know, it's amazing how state media, well, as I like to call it, you know, and you know the culprits, man, CNN, MSNBC, and all the network news, of course, such as ABC, which is absolute trash. It amazes me how these so-called journalists, they just can't seem to call things out. They refuse to look into anything else if it doesn't fit their narrative, for one. And they just want to try to just basically make up crap, just straight up lie. Set a narrative, lying to you, gaslighting, you know the usual, man. This video here, man, with chief propagandist here of ABC, George Stephanopoulos, which I call him George Propagandist, because it's exactly what this bull crap is that he's pulling here with Byron Donalds. You're going to see this here, and believe me, it's amazing, man. Just watching this dude, he's let's face it, he's a piece of crap, man. I swear he is. You know, I don't care what he does on GMA, or if I believe he's there with Robin Harris, which is Robin Harris is awesome. Even though she's a lefty, she's good. She's cool. I got no problem with Robin Harris. Michael Strahan, but this dude here, man, George, he bugs me. He bugs me. I'm not going to lie, he does. Every time when I see this dude, him talking, just the crap that comes out of his mouth is just like, dude, you trash. But anyway, I digress. You know, let's move on to this interview that he does with Byron Donalds here about the latest comments that's up in a roar from Donald Trump here, man. This controversy talking about Kamala Harris's heritage, you should say, her racial identity, her racial heritage. It's, come on, man. Look, I just did a video about this, seriously, you know, where Judge Joe Brown just basically eviscerated this woman, and he called out exactly what I called out years ago about this woman, okay? So her trying to identify as black, which she's not, and she's only identifying as that because she wants a black vote, whatever. Typical lying-ass Democrat. Pander, pander, pander. That's all they know, you know? If she needed a white supremacist vote or something like that, I swear she'd probably be marching out there with a burning cross. Who knows? That's what Democrats do, seeing how they're the ones who spawned the Klan anyway. But that's another conversation for another time. But anyway, take a look at this here with Mr. George Propagandist, and then tell me what you think.
Just bring in Republican Congressman and Trump ally Byron Donalds. Congressman, thank you for joining us this morning. Why is former President Trump questioning the Vice President's racial identity?
Well, first, George, in Chicago, he was responding to a question from, I believe, Rachel Scott. Like, this is really a phony controversy. I don't really care. Most people don't.
Right.
But if we're going to be accurate, when Kamala Harris went into the United States Senate, it was AP that said she was the first Indian American United States Senator. It was actually played up a lot
when she came
into the Senate. Now she's running nationally. Obviously, the campaign has shifted. They're talking much more about her father's heritage and her black identity. It doesn't really matter. The president mentioned it. What he also talks about far more frequently is the fact that Kamala Harris is the person who created this massive inflation, which is destroying black families, white families, Hispanic families. It's her failure as border czar that has left our southern border wide open, more than 10 million illegal immigrants coming into our country, record fentanyl coming into our country, which has killed more Americans than at any other point in the history of our country with respect specifically to fentanyl, and the fact that she and Joe Biden have unleashed one of the worst foreign policies in the history of our country that has us on the verge of World War III. That is Kamala Harris's record. President Trump talks about that frequently, but yes, he did mention it in Chicago in response to a question from Rachel Scott.
And you just repeated the slur again. If it doesn't matter, why do you all keep questioning her identity? She's always identified as a black woman. She is biracial.
Okay. Yes, she's biracial to a very small degree. To a very small degree. Like I said in my video, okay, break it down to her. Like I said, same thing. Judge Joe Brown was right. I was right when I said it before and researched even more, and I was still right about the simple fact that, yes, her daddy's a mixed Jamaican, okay? Somehow these fools, such as this fool here, thinks that, I guess if you're born in Jamaica, you must be black, I guess. You must have, unless you want to go by that basic one-drop rule that was created, what? As white supremacists would say back in the day, what, hundreds of years ago, if you had one drop of black blood in you, I guess you considered black. So then could you make the question that if, what other nationalities is at that same degree? Okay. Can you make that same claim to Native American Indians? Okay. Could you make that same claim to Hispanics? Can you make that same claim to whites? How about Asians? I mean, come on now. How far does this go? It gets ridiculous to a point, even with this crap here, what this clown thinks. I mean, because one finds from Jamaica. Yeah, like I said, man, I mean, Jamaica was under British Commonwealth. There's all kinds of ethnicities that were born in Jamaica. It doesn't make you Jamaican just because it doesn't make you black, okay? Black is a race. Jamaica is a nation. It's just nationality, not race. So her daddy being a mixed Jamaican, East Indian, and half Irish, where's the black lineage at? Once again, her mother was 100% East Indian. Where is it? It's not there. So stop.
She has a Jamaican father and Indian mother. She's always identified as both. Why are you questioning that?
Questioning because you're an idiot. You're an idiot, George. This is, like I said, this dude is just a moron, man. He's a Jamaican father and an Indian mother. It's like, hey, fool. There's other nations, there's other races of people that were born in Jamaica that makes them Jamaican by nationality standards. Okay? Same thing here. I'm born here and I'm an American first of African descent. Okay? It's the same damn thing. The hell out of here. God, this dude is such a moron. And the propaganda that just comes out of the left, man, is just sickening.
Well, George, first of all, this is something that's actually a conversation throughout social media right now. There are a lot of people who are trying to figure this out. But again, that's a side issue, not the main issue.
No joke.
The main issue.
Sir, one second. You just did it. You just did it again.
Vice President of the United States.
Why do you insist on questioning her racial identity?
You want me to talk?
I want you to answer my question.
George, now that you're done yelling at me, let me answer. He talked about it on the stage yesterday in Atlanta for, what, 2 minutes? He spent more than 35, 40 minutes going after her record, talking about how radical of a senator that she was. She was the most liberal senator in the United States Senate. That is a fact. He talked about the job that she did as vice president of the United States, a job, I will add, which has been a failure for the American people. I know you guys like to glom on to this that he talks about in jest or in a serious manner for about a minute or so, but what you do not cover is the litany of failures of Kamala Harris.
No,
that's
joke.
What you're not covering, George.
So questioning somebody's racial identity for a couple minutes is okay?
George, I'm going to tell you again, he brought it up. AP is the one that wrote the headline when she first came in to the United States Senate.
Sure.
Didn't talk about her being black. Talked about her being the first Indian American senator. AP brought that up.
And we'll pause it right there because outside of the article that AP brought it up, there's also a video showing her being sworn in by Joe Biden as well as the first Indian senator being brought in. Check this out.
Good to see you, man.
How are you?
You know you're my way up. You know that, right? All right. We're going to have you stand in the middle.
Okay.
And Kamala, you stand out.
Okay.
We're going to reenact the ceremony and then we're going to bring in your folks, okay?
Well,
you ready? All right. That's a good way to do it.
Okay.
All right?
Yes.
Put your left hand in the Bible, raise your right. Do you solemnly swear to support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic? That you'll bear true faith and allegiance to the same, that you take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion, and you will well and faithfully discharge the duties of the office upon which you're about to enter to help you God.
I do.
I don't have a doubt in my mind. Now,
Thank you
got some family out here?
Thank you. Come on, family. I got quite a crew.
Well, great to see you. Do you guys know what they're...
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Thank you, Mr. Gladys is reading one of the three at heart, if anybody wants Mattis.
And then extended families, if you don't.
Oh, no.
Okay, come on, everybody. Crew.
Come on,
extended family. My extended family is here.
Hi, how are you? Nice to see you again. How are you?
President.
How are you, man? Sit down and jump around the back.
Come on.
You've done this before.
Man, good to see you. How are you? Nice to see you. How are you? Welcome.
Best friend from kindergarten. This is my best.
I mean, George, we could have this conversation for the entire segment, but none of this matters to the American people. What matters to the American people is, are we going to have the same policies of the Biden-Harris administration that has been destructive of the American people?
That's right.
Or are we going to have the policies of the Trump administration, which put America first, had low inflation, prosperous Americans, no matter your race, no matter your color, no matter your creed, and a foreign policy that kept America safe? Those are the facts that truly matter, because this issue is going to come and go. The lives of the American people is what's going to remain, and that's what matters more than anything else.
If it doesn't matter, I don't understand why you keep on repeating it, why the president keeps on repeating it, why those introducing the president yesterday
George,
keep
actually,
on repeating
I'm
it.
Not the one who keeps repeating it. George, you're the one that's bringing it up now.
And that's exactly it, is what he's talking about. Nobody's repeating this outside the media from the left. They're the ones who are constantly repeating this and bringing this up. Constantly trying to have a conversation to move on from this crap, but it's kind of hard because the left media keeps bringing this damn topic up. Okay, that's the truth. So anytime when you're watching this crap between clowns like George here, he's still talking about this. They still talk about it now. They're trying to make an issue out of this. They started out Kamala's campaign, or even when they'd shove this woman up front and start bringing up race and heritage. This is coming from the left that started this crap, all right? And what the thing is here now, I'm trying to see as to where if Republicans are not going to get baited into this crap talking about this woman's race, okay? Donald Trump put it out there, and he just said the quiet part out loud. But the gaslighting coming from the left, they're not paying attention to realizing that a lot of black folks, agree with Donald Trump saying, hey, this woman ran as an East Indian she ran as an Indian senator for how long? Even when she was district attorney, I believe, and then went from the AG, from that to the AG, and the AG to the Senate. Okay? A prosecuting attorney. District attorney. However you want to put it. Either one. That's how she ran on this whole damn thing. So then her coming out saying she identifies as she's black, and it's like, well, woman, you don't have black lineage in your family. Anywhere, how far back can you go? You know, because it sure as hell ain't in your immediate family. That's for damn sure. So what are you talking about? But the thing is people like George keep talking about this whole issue here, saying that, you know, You keep saying that slur and you keep asking about a race. It's like you keep bringing it up. Stop bringing it up. Move on to it. We're trying to move on to our policies. You keep bringing up what Donald Trump said about a race, questioning her heritage. We're done with it. We're over it. Okay? The woman's not black. Stop calling her black. We're done with it. Okay? Simple as that.
That's
you've
you.
Done it,
why
sir.
You
you've done it.
Up.
You've because done it three times. Every single answer George, you gave me. Now let me finish, sir.
George,
every single you answer you gave,
me,
you repeated
you
the slur.
Asked me, George. That's why I'm pushing back on you now.
What's
George,
the slur?
You asked me the question three times. I responded, but I'm
and every single time you repeat the slur. That is my, exactly my point.
What is the
you
slur?
You simply can't say that it's wrong,
George. So then what you're saying? So then what? And I want to get off this topic because it's not the only thing that's going on. But George, now you're saying that AP is the one that slurred Kamala Harris because
right.
those are the facts.
That's right.
You can go to the internet and look at the clips, George,
that's
if you want
right.
to, or we can talk about this now. I prefer
the one I just showed you was 7 years old, 7 years ago when she was sworn in. That was AP's. Okay? So he's right about this.
To talk about the future of our country, because the American people are struggling. The American people do need serious policy decisions to be made, and they need serious leadership on the world stage. Kamala Harris has not proven that she can do that. Donald J. Trump has proven that he can do that.
AP did not say that Kamala Harris is not black. She is biracial. She is Indian. She is black. You continue to repeat the fact that you continue to repeat the slur. I don't understand why you and the president do it, but it's clear you're not going to say that it's wrong.
Because it's not wrong, George, and it's not a slur. She is not black. I'm a black man. Okay? Kamala Harris is not. I am amongst millions of black folks, millions that look at this woman and say, okay, I don't know why they keep calling her black because she's not black. So why they keep riding it? Why come they keep hammering on it? It's not black. Not stupid, man. We're not stupid. You can look up this woman's family. Just pull it up. I told and I said it millions and millions of times before. We're all running around with a supercomputer in our pockets every single damn day. Every day, all day. All of us are. You can find out this information within seconds, if not just minutes, a few minutes, you can find this stuff out. It amazes me that this clown, Austin, he honestly is trying to get Byron Donaldson to condemn or say that what was that Donald Trump brought that up when he mentioned that and try to condemn it as wrong and paint it as wrong. And it's like, no, Byron's not going to take it because he knows it's not wrong. She's not black. You keep bringing it up and we want to move on to something else, but you guys on the left keep bringing this crap up. So shut the hell up about this woman's race and her heritage, for one, because she's not black. Now move on. You can't go from claiming your entire life going East Indian. You see your heritage from your family's tree. You see your line, the family line from right there, outside of the fact that I believe on the white side of her father being mixed, his side of his family, the white side of his family, also owned slaves in Jamaica. Nothing said about that. He don't want to dig too far and too deep in on that, though. But like I said, George is stupid. He's very stupid. Very dumb man. Her father's from Jamaica. He must be black. Clown, dude. Clown. And no, he's not going to condemn it because it's not wrong.
And you've now established that. For our audience, Trump also said at the convention that he would pardon January 6th rioters.
Everybody look for themselves. Let's move on.
That's right.
I've already said that. Go ahead.
On the internet, everybody. Let's move on.
That's right.
Here we go.
It's out there.
Go on and repeat the slurs again.
Shut up, clown, and just talk.
Trump also said at the convention that he would pardon January 6th rioters who assaulted police officers. Do you support that?
Actually, what he said is that he was going to review every single case. He even repeated that again in Chicago at the NABJ. Listen, what we do understand is that the Department of Justice under Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, they did massively push up charges on people who protested at the Capitol and some who rioted at the Capitol on January 6th. So what he's talking about is doing a case-by-case review. You can lump it all together all you want, but those are the words of Donald J. Trump. I'm quite sure on the internet people can pull up that clips. They can watch it at their own leisure.
I'll read it to you right now. This was Rachel Scott's question. My question is on those rioters who assaulted officers. Would you pardon those people? Oh, absolutely, I would. That's his words.
But you didn't give it the rest of the
yes,
words
but
he
you
said.
What you did not leave in was the rest of his comments where he said, yeah, I would, but we want to look at everything on a case-by-case basis.
And he's right. And I got that for you, too. If you weren't paying attention to that interview, check this out.
Were the people who assaulted those 140 officers, including those I just mentioned, patriots who deserve pardons?
Well, let me bring it back to modern day. Like about 5 days ago, we had an attack on the Capitol, a horrible attack on the Capitol. You saw the people that were protesting and spraying these incredible monuments, bells, lions, all these magnificent limestone and granite with red paint, red spray paint, that will never actually come off, especially on the limestone. It will never, I'm a builder, I know about this stuff. It'll never, you'll see it in 100 years from now. They viciously attacked our government. They fought with police. They fought with them much more openly than I saw on January 6th. What's going to happen to those people? What's going to happen to the people in Portland that destroyed that city?
But, sir, my question
city?
Is on those.
What's going to happen to
my
the people that tried
to
bring
rioters
it?
Who assaulted
Excuse
officers?
Me. You have to
would
ask,
you pardon
what's
those
gonna
people?
What's going to happen? Oh, absolutely I would.
You if would pardon
innocent,
those?
If they're innocent, I would pardon them.
They've been convicted.
And by the way, the Supreme Court just under... Well, they were convicted by a very tough system.
That's what will happen, George.
No, that's not what he said. He said if they were innocent, I would pardon them. Okay. They've all been convicted. He said he would pardon those who assaulted police officers. Do what you support that or not?
George, you just changed the soundbite. You just changed it. Now you added, if they're innocent, then I will pardon them. Let's go back to the record of January 6th. Again, not something that matters.
I didn't change the soundbite. That's exactly what he said. They've been convicted.
George, the first thing you said was, yes, I'll pardon them. Then you extended
and he said that.
Say, if they are innocent, then yes, I will. That's what you said, George. Now I'm responding. Okay. So what he's saying is that, yeah, I will go and look at these cases. If they're innocent, yes, I will. Of course, if somebody was beating up a police officer at January 6th, he's not going to do that. But if you had people who were just walking through the Capitol, which did occur on January 6th, because the security protocols had changed because of that riot at the Capitol, then what he would do is not allow them to be held in jail with these massively increased charges by the current U.S. attorney in D.C. under the Biden-Harris administration.
And that's right, because that's exactly what Trump said. Once again, George Propagandus is sitting here trying to change it. And Brian's right. He just changed the soundbite right there. And he did. And Trump said that. He said, if they're innocent, and which means exactly it, he's going to go back over and have to look at it case by case to see if they're innocent or not. Because he's right. They were massively trumped up on egregious charges that were just massively induced on these people that were there. Some of them said, well, they were convicted. Some of these convictions were so out of... unbelievably ridiculous. It's like, yeah, you got to go over case by case and going, okay, this charge here, this makes no sense. Nobody gets charged this much or anything. What was going on as far as the rioters and the charges they received? Yes, they're extremely outrageous. So you'd have to go over them by case by case to find out. And if it seems to be so, they had charges that were massively, how can you say, overreach, or should say just huge, massive charges that shouldn't be that high, then yeah, I'd pardon him. I would too. I'm like, this is ridiculous. You shouldn't have got a charge that high, you know, for just being there on public ground. Unbelievable.
Compare that to the fact that at the rally that the riots that just occurred at Union Station, when Bibi Netanyahu was speaking to Congress, you had the same U.S. attorney for the District of Columbia who decided to just let people go and not file any charges, even though they were defacing monuments at Union Square. So we want to be fair with the justice system. We don't want to be political with the justice system.
And it's right, because all of that was on video. A lot of this stuff was live. And it was showing the protests that was going on. It's all there. Even ABC looked at it and they covered it. So.
My question is on those rioters who assaulted officers. Would you pardon those people? Donald Trump. Oh, absolutely, I would.
Here this
would
clown is coming
if
back.
If they were innocent,
this.
I would pardon them. That is the entire quote. They are not innocent. They are convicted. He said he would pardon them.
Once again, George, we watched the interview. I got it. Recorded the whole thing. You're changing it, man. I told you, this is propaganda at work coming from state media.
And George, what I'm telling you is he's going to go back and look at these cases, because it is without a doubt And look, January 6th is a very painful memory in our country, but it is without a doubt that the U.S. Attorney for the District of Columbia was supercharging these people because of political viewpoints. Because you had other riots that have occurred in Washington, D.C., where the charges were minimized or dismissed altogether. That is not an even-handed system of justice. That is a politically motivated system of justice. And you don't have to look any further than the difference between how the Department of Justice has treated Donald Trump versus how the Department of Justice has treated Joe Biden or Hillary Clinton.
Absolutely.
What he is talking about is equal enforcement of the law, not picking and choosing because of your politics.
And that's true.
I would remind you that this Department of Justice actually indicted Hunter Biden, the president's son. And of course, we were talking about assaults
only
on police officers, people who
were
convicted
exactly.
for assaults on police officers, which the president has said he would pardon them.
Stop, clown. Look,
let me
finish
time.
This up here. You know what, man? This dude, I'm telling you, seriously, it's unbelievable. It's unbelievable that he would even bring that crap up about Hunter Biden. And Byron Donalds was right. They only convicted him because they had no choice. They had to pin something on it to make it look like there's equal justice being served after that sham trial that was going on in New York with Donald Trump. The weakest case out of any of all of them that nobody really cared about, that was a complete sham that we all know, that we saw it for 5 weeks, and that he got railroaded on all of that bull crap and had trial there. Then right after that, well, we got to find something to get Hunter Biden so we can make it look good. But you notice how they didn't bring up anything about the taxes, stuff like that, which that's trying to come up. And they go after him on the weakest damn charge possible that they convicted him on. And that was a damn gun charge. So, okay, falsifying a government document for trying to purchase a firearm, which... yeah, I mean, you can look at jail time for that. Yeah, it's serious. But let's talk about the money as far as what he owes, as far as millions in taxes or something like that. Oh, can't talk about that. Not that one. We're not going to get him on that one. We're not going to get him on possible all the shell companies or anything else that his name is tied to along with his daddy in there. No, well, you notice how that got real hush-hush real quick. After a while, when he talked about it, and all of a sudden it kind of just faded away. Now it's talking about as far as tax evasion on some of this, too. But no, they didn't go after him on that. And on top of that, they let the statute run out on what was, forgot that one case. I had to bring it up, man. I'll dig it up again because, like I said, it went hush hush and forgot about it. And everything else has been going on so much. This news cycle of this election year, man, is insane. There is so much crap going on and trying to keep up with all of it. And it's all coming at once. And it's a lot of stuff, man. It wind up losing it. You know what I mean? As far as trying to stay on top of and talk about it. But anyway, this interview, man, with just like I said, just network news is just trash, man. Same thing. And George propagandist, because that's exactly what he does, is it's amazing. It's amazing just listening to the bull crap that comes out of this dude. And this interview was just ridiculous, man. You know, shout out to Byron Donalds, man. Keeping it straight, keeping it cool. That's a lot. I love Byron Donalds, man. He just sticks right to it. He's like, dude, look, you know, boom, 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 boom. I'm not going off into the weeds. It was said, it was done. Let's move on. And he's right. It's said, it's done. Let's move on, okay? The woman, yes, the woman's not black. She's going to lie her way all the way to election saying that she's black. The left is going to use this constantly for anybody here on the right, any conservatives. You know it's going to get shut down anywhere on social media at some point. It's going to start shadow banning certain content about this woman. That's coming. Just like before on Facebook, YouTube, all the other platforms except for X. So pretty much, I guess I'm going to have to get more active on my X account. You can find me over there too at It's Bishop as well, _ It's Bishop. You can find me over there on X. It's crazy, man. It's crazy. But I'm having fun with it. I'm fascinated by a lot of this stuff, man. I'm just fascinated as far as how much and how far the left going to stretch the lies. That's my biggest thing. So, I mean, the bold-faced lies right to your face. Can they top it? It almost seems like every single day the news cycle comes up and they try to find out, okay, which lie can we top and make it better than the last lie that we just told you either an hour ago or yesterday? Can we find one bigger than that? Can we stretch the truth anymore on something? Or not even stretch the truth, just start stretching lies, really, because it really ain't telling the truth. what they call the truth. They take everything out of context, but that's just me rambling and ranting on this, man, because I can't stand state media. I can't stand the left stream liberal media, man. I can't stand it, dude. It's like, God, they just irritate my ass. They do. But anyway, guys, tell me what you think. Let me know, man. And let me know in the comments below, man. And seriously, do you really believe this woman is black? I said in my other video before, she's not. Do you think the left is ever going to let this go just because Trump brought this up? Think they're going to let it go? No, they're going to try to ride this thing all the way through. They're doing everything possible to erase this woman's history and rewrite history. She's pandering and flip-flopping on all the other crap before that she stood on for how many of her entire career. Now, all of a sudden, well, she's against all this stuff now. She just changed her mind. She's not really for that now. This woman is a fraud, big-time fraud. That's why I can't stand her. She's an absolute fake. So, anyway, let me know what you think, man, and I'll be sure to see you guys again on the next one here real soon.